Hi, beautiful people. How are ya? I hope you're having a great day.
With you, I can be sad. With you, just take my hand and fly up through the dreams where the skies are so clear.
First, I want to say thank you to all of you for your grace and understanding as I work through all of my feelings. I'm doing much better. I took it easy for several days. And I'll be honest, that was difficult and hard to sit still because I knew I had things that I wanted to do. I just couldn't do them. I've been flaring, but I'm coming out of it. And I've been resting a lot because physically, the numbness, pain, and sudden sharp pain I've been experiencing, along with the tingling and burning in my feet, hands, wrists, hips, and my legs, and the muscle spasms have been draining me. So I saw a neurologist a couple of days ago, and I have an appointment in September, which will get here faster than we know, to get an EMG on both of my legs to see what's going on there. We'll see what comes of that. It may be fibromyalgia causing these pains that a lot of us just get, or it may be something else, but I'm trying to take care of myself. The doctor did up my dosage of Neurontin at nighttime, because that was when I was getting the worst shooting pain and some burning pain. Oh my goodness, it almost completely takes away my hip pain. So that's really nice. My blood work looks really good. No heavy metal problems. I don't have a thyroid issue and other things he checked looks good. But we'll see what the doctor says. I have an appointment with my nurse practitioner on Tuesday. Today is Sunday for my checkup. I took my daughter to the dentist a couple Fridays ago and Cadence came along. Stephanie had to get two of her wisdom teeth pulled that were causing her pain. And Cadence took this pick at Walgreens when we were getting Stephanie's prescription. She's so clever. She took it by facing the camera at the mirror on the upper wall. If any of you've been in Walgreens, you know there's this up high, this big mirror that goes across the back of the building. You can tell my daughter isn't feeling very well. To have a little fun in my life, I went to church in person last Sunday. I sat with my youngest son. My daughter wasn't feeling well from her wisdom teeth pulling, so she wasn't there. Today, Sunday, I watched church online. I spent an afternoon with my three granddaughters last Tuesday. Oh, what fun that was. We had lunch, went to Starbucks. The girls love Starbucks. And we walked around Hobby Lobby. When I got home, I was wiped out. And remember that wreath I hung? Well, it fell to the floor. So my husband bought this mounting tape that is supposed to work in extreme temperatures. I think the tape that was holding up that hook got overwhelmed by the high temperatures we were having and stopped sticking. So hopefully it'll stay up this time around. I just need to put it up. Our oven decided to quit working, which isn't a good thing for my chef-like husband. So we had one delivered yesterday. Yay. It looks a lot like our other one, except this one has a regular oven, a convection oven, and an air fryer built into it. Isn't technology cool? I know I'm feeling better because I went outside with Tesla in the backyard and started pulling weeds. I did that Friday. It rained that morning a little bit, so the weeds mostly pulled out easily. And then I came back inside and started working on this script. Sitting here helps me when I've been on my feet. And then at the same time, too much sitting causes my hips to hurt and my feet to go numb. So I have to stand and stretch periodically. Today is about fibromyalgia medications. I wanted to give you a rundown of what is out there. You're going to know many of these, especially if you've had fiber a long time. You're probably a lot like me where you've been through many of them. I just hope that you don't live in pain every day. I know that I tend to endure pain so that I don't have to be medicated, but sometimes it's necessary so that we can get things done and live our lives happily. Pain can cause us distress, and that can cause a vicious cycle of more pain, and that's not good for anybody. For most of us, it takes a while to figure out what works for us, but there is a lot that we can do, so we push forward. Here we go. I want to get this one out of the way because I think this is a difficult topic for many of you. Some studies show that pharmacological treatments involving opioids are not beneficial for fibromyalgia. The risk of addiction is high. Despite this knowledge, opioids are commonly prescribed as a treatment for individuals with fibromyalgia. In Indiana, you would have to have something really life-threatening and extremely painful to even get a prescription for an opioid. A few doctors in Indiana either lost their license or they're not allowed to practice in the state of Indiana any longer for overprescribing and misuse of opioids. So it's a big deal here. And I'm sure that doctors fear the idea of losing their license, so they don't prescribe this medication without a really good reason. And because fibro isn't on the list has a really good reason. Our National Institute of Health strongly stated in a 2021 study, opioids are not recommended for the treatment of fibromyalgia under current guidelines. Quote, a greater burden of illness appeared to be associated with the prescription and use of opioids in this population, unquote. There were 698 participants in that study, and 27.1% were on opioids at intake. That's disturbing. But four carefully selected patients with fibromyalgia, particularly with those with severe symptoms, in the short term, opioids may be recommended according to the guidelines, so it's not an absolute no. The key, though, is short term. However, I know that in other states and countries in the world, it is a supported treatment for fibro, and some of you may have an overlapping condition that requires an opiate. To understand why researchers don't support opioid use in fibro, we must look at research. So I'll try to quickly break this down. Quote, from Mayo Clinic proceedings, however, medical guidelines, including those of the American Pain Society and the American Academy of Pain Medicine, the American Academy of Neurology, the European League Against Rheumatism, the Canadian Pain Society, and the Canadian Rheumatology Association, and the British Pain Society recommend against the use of long-term opioids in fibromyalgia. Opioid-induced hyperalgesia, and hyperalgesia is an abnormally heightened sensitivity to pain, is defined as a state of nociceptive, meaning related to pain, sensitization caused by exposure to opioids, meaning when a patient with fibromyalgia receives opioids for the treatment of pain, they could become more sensitive to certain painful stimuli. It's also believed that our own opioid system that helps with pain may have a more activated receptor at rest with an increased release of endogenous, meaning what's inside of us, opioids, and reduced receptor availability. Or we may have fewer opioid receptors leading to pain. In another study, the use of oral morphine in fibromyalgia patients opioid medication for pain relief of fibromyalgia patients reported continued severe pain in 49% of them. Despite these facts, 10 to 60% of patients are prescribed opioids. This is usually because of patients requesting opioids due to the thought that opioids are stronger or better, or because the FDA-approved meds aren't effective. Short-term use may be effective in certain patients, but long-term effects will make matters worse. Tramadol is considered a weak opioid with combined U receptor agonist and 5-HT and norepinephrine reuptake inhibition activity. It is this latter action that is possibly the key to its efficacy in fibro compared to other opioids. It is a controlled substance. It is prescribed to treat moderate to severe pain. Although tramadol is prescribed rarely for fibro, I thought I would still mention it because if an opioid is prescribed, this is most likely the one. Unfortunately, long-term efficacy and optimal dose of tramadol have not been addressed in clinical trials. I've never taken this before, but when I had a bad cough from bronchitis, I took a codeine and acetaminophen combination as a temporary med taken for a few days, and tramadol and codeine are similar. Tramadol is a synthetic opioid, and codeine is a natural opioid called an opiate. There are warnings about the difficulty of withdrawing, too, but when taken as prescribed, withdrawal should be minimal unless you have taken it for a long period of time. And most importantly, I would never want to hear that someone overdosed on this med because they took more than they should. Tramadol has been explored for the management of fibro pain and symptoms. In a 2020 study, researchers stated that although its inhibitory action of reuptake of neurotransmitters is understood, its safety and efficacy have not been established for fibro patients. But an analgesic with tramadol did improve the quality of life of these individuals, but alone it did not. So tramadol with like acetaminophen, there was no improvement in depression or sleep quality, and it was rated as low using the GRADE approach. I know that pain is hard. I understand that when you take a med that works, you love feeling good again. I get that. But technically, only three medications have been approved by the FDA for the use in fibromyalgia. And those are milnacipran, duloxetine, and pregabalin. So this video cut pretty long, so I split it in two. I hope you're okay with that. I hope you learned something. I send you gentle hugs and support. Love you.
With you, I can be sad with you. Just take my.
What's that oven that part that does the hot air called?
The skies are so clear.
What's the other one? Oh.
I wanna stay with you.
There's my clock.
With you. I love the way that you love me today. Let's run.